देखो अब हम लोग का है डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन ऑफ द फर्स्ट ऑर्डर एंड डिग्री मोर देन वन। हियर वी विल डिनोट डीवाई बाय डीएक्स बाय स्मॉल पी। द मोस्ट जनरल फॉर्म ऑफ डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन ऑफ द फर्स्ट ऑर्डर एट द nth डिग्री इज पी टू द पावर एन प्लस क्यू वन पी टू द पावर एन माइनस वन प्लस क्यू टू पी टू द पावर एन माइनस टू प्लस वन प्लस क्यू वन इक्वल टू जीरो। So it is a polynomial in P. Here Q1, Q2, so on, Qn, they are functions of X or Y or both. And small p is u divided by dx. So first we will make components, rational components, or say we will factorize the left hand side into linear factors. Or second, the left hand side is solvable for x, for y, or it is one of the form of Clairaut's equation. First we will study that our left hand side is linearly factorized. See here, left hand side resolvable into factors means equations solvable for p. See here some more concepts. The left hand side of the equation can be resolved into rational factors linear in the derivative. The left hand side of the equation cannot be so linearly factorized in another case. When the first case exists, the equation is solvable for p. It is our 4.2. As regarding the case 2, the differential equations are of the following type: first, solvable for y; second, solvable for x; and third, it is of Clairaut's equation. So let the general form of the differential equation of the first order in nth degree be p to the power n plus q1 p to the power n minus 1 plus q2 p to the power n minus 2 plus 1 plus qn equal to 0. We will factorize the above equation 1. Suppose the factors are p minus 1, p minus 2, p minus 3, so on, p minus n. Then their product will be 0. And where a1, a2, so on, an are, they are functions of x, y, or both. It implies that p minus a1 b will be 0, p minus a2 is 0, p minus a3 is 0, and so on, p minus an is 0. Then for a solution from 2, it will also be solution of this, and hence the given equation. Let the solutions derived from this 2 p is divided by, remember that p is divided by dx, and this a1 is function of x, y, or both. So it can be solvable by our earlier methods. Suppose the solutions of these equations are, or these linear factors are, f1 x, y, c1 equal to 0, f2 x, y, c2 equal to 0, and so on, fn x, y, and cn is equal to 0, where c1, c2, so on, cn, they are constants of integration. We multiply all of them to make one single solution, f1 x y c1 into f2 x y c2 into so on, fn x y cn is equal to 0. We can replace all the constants of integration c1 c2 so on cn by a single constant c. There is no problem. So the our general complete solution here will be f1 x y c into f2 x y c into so on, fn x y c is equal to 0. See here one example. Solve p square minus p e to the power x plus e to the power minus x plus 1 equal to 0, where p is divided by dx. It can be written as p square minus p e to the power x minus p to the power minus x plus 1 equal to 0. Take p here common and take here minus 1 common, or e to the power x here common. So it will be p into p minus e to the power x minus e to the power minus x p in minus e to the power x equal to 0. So p minus e to the power x is common. So take its common, tp minus e to the power x into p minus e to the power minus x equal to 0. So we have two linear factors. It implies that p minus e to the power x is equal to 0. And the second one is p minus e to the power minus x is 0. From the first, dy by dx will be e to the power x. So its solution will be y is equal to e to the power x plus c, where c is a constant of integration. So y minus e to the power x is equal to c. From the second, dy by dx will be e to the power minus x. So y will be its solution will be y is equal to device group minus 3x df. So y will be minus 3x square by 2 plus c, or y plus 3x square by 2 is equal to c. Again, when p is equal to x, then dy by dx is equal to x, then dy is equal to x dx. One second. Okay, this equation is solved here. Okay, so this is our solution for the second one. Y is equal to minus e to power minus x plus c, or y plus e to power minus x is equal to c. Multiply both of them. So the complete solution will be y minus e to the power x minus c into y plus e to the power minus x minus c equal to 0. This is our complete solution. See one more example. P square plus 2xp minus 3x square is equal to 0. We can factorize this as p plus 3x into p minus x equal to 0. Multiply them. P square minus xp plus 3xp minus 3x equal to 0. So it will be p square plus 2xp minus 3x square is equal to 0. It implies that p is equal to minus 3x and p is equal to x. For p is equal to minus 3x, dy by dx will be minus 3x. So y dy is equal to minus 3x dx. It means after integration we get y is equal to minus 3x square by 2 plus c. So y plus 3x square by 2 is equal to c. This is our first solution. And the second, from p is equal to x, dy by dx is yes. So x will, y will be x square by 2 plus c. Combine these two, then we will get y plus 3x square by 2 minus c into y minus x square by 2 minus c equal to 0. This is our complete solution. If you want to see another example, see here, x into dy by dx whole square plus y minus x dy by dx minus y is equal to 0. It is xp square plus y minus xp minus y equal to 0. The given equation can be written as xp square plus y minus xp minus y equal to 0, or xp square plus yp minus xp minus y equal to 0. Open this bracket. Now, it will be xp square plus yp minus xp plus y equal to 0. Take here p common, so it will be p into xp plus y. This is minus 1 into p xp plus y. So we have xp plus y as common. So you can solve this. It is not a tough task. Xp, take here p common, so it will be p minus 1 into xp plus y. So p is equal to 1 and p is equal to y by x. So we have two equations. You can solve it by earlier method. Next, another case is when left side cannot be resolved into linear factors. Then we will look for whether it is solvable for y, or whether it is solvable for x, or whether the given equation is of Clairaut's form. See, when equation is solvable for y, when the given differential equation can be put in the form y is equal to fxp. See here, y is equal to fxp, it should be our form of the equation. Then we say that it is solvable for y. Differentiated with respect to x, so it will be dy by dx. This is equal to dy dx fxp, or it is your phi xp dp over dx. So it will be another function phi of x, p and dp over dx. It means this is your p, so p will be phi xp dp over dx. Now, it can be solved for p, which is an equation of the first order and first degree. Here p is a dependent variable and x is independent variable. This can be solved by our previous method. Suppose the solution is x xp f xp c is equal to 0. This is our capital F. Now the solution of this one is can be obtained in two ways. First, eliminate p between equation 1 and equation 2. Then you get a relation between x, y and c, which is the required solution. And if you cannot eliminate p between equation 1 and equation 2, then write the equation in the form x is equal to f1pc and y is equal to f2pc. So in these two forms, you can also write the solution of y is equal to fxp, means for those equations which are solvable for y. If you want to see one example, see here. y is equal to p sin p plus cos p. So it is an equation solvable for y, not for p, because p is here in sine and cos. So it is not solvable for p, it is solvable for y only. So differentiated with respect to x, it will be dy by dx equal to p into cos p into dp over dx plus sin p dp over dx. And this is cos p, so its differentiation is minus sin p dp over dx. Here p is missing. So p, this is p, p is equal to p cos p dp over dx, because these two cancel each other. It means cos p dp over dx is equal to 1. PP cancel each other. Or dx is equal to cos p dp. It implies that dx will be integration cos p dp. It implies that x is equal to sin p plus. C after integration. Hence, the general solution of the equation will be x is equal to sin p plus c first. And second, y is this one. Y is equal to p sin p plus cos p. So both of them taken together will give you the solution of this problem. Here, it is tough to eliminate p between x is equal to sin p plus c and the given equation y is equal to p sin p plus cos p. So we will use second method, write the equation in the form x is equal to f1 pc and y is equal to f2 pc. So this is also, you can write the solution in this form also. Here p is a parameter. If we can solve, evaluate p, then the solution will be only one equation. But if we cannot evaluate p, we will write it in this form. X is equal to fpc, y is equal to f2pc. So write down all of them. And you have, if you have any query, ask me.